Okay guys, let's start from this one, which is just my exercise t-shirt. And why I want to take in a neck, and why anybody want to take in a neck, because you know, it's look good on the table. By the time what you put in, it's sliding all over you. And for young people, off shoulder look, you know, that big cuts is okay. But for people like in the mid age, and if you keep this top or t-shirt or blouse for some certain purpose, you always follow purpose. Usually people who know style, they do not mix. If you keep this garment, you know exactly which occasion you wearing that, which occasion you not wearing that. No, well, you kind of have your stock for not just for job separate and for casual stock. You also have differences between your job stock, more dressy, less dressy, completely dressy, and so is casual clothes. Casual clothes can be different occasion for your weekend. No, well, that's why you kind of have to, if people who know style always have that, first of all, go by purpose of that garment. No, well, for me, purpose of this garment, it's a walking in mountains, walking in the park. That's my exercise t-shirt. No, well, what I gonna do? I don't need, because I'm a white skinned woman, as you can see, and sun does damage for me all over in California. No, well, even with sunblock, I really have to make sure what I'm covering. I'm covered, that's why it's kind of off shoulders, plus this one is go right below my elbow. As much as less sunblock I put on myself, which is I have very sensitive skin, and any kind of sunblock, even those approved by doctors, always break me. It's don't break me from first time use, but it will break me eventually. That's why I have to look as less use as possible. That's why what if it's not sunblock, what it's going to be, it's going to be covering, good covering. And it's very nice, very 100%, I believe it's 100% cotton. I believe it's 100% cotton. Oh, they don't even put 95 rayon and 5 spandex. That's a good, because rayon is practically a type of cotton. Well, that's why it's very good. It's very good, very comfortable, good coverage for spring and summer, but I need to make that hole smaller, what I will have more coverage around my neck. No, well, always look on what, when you deal with closing this neckline, always look on how many seams you got. You only have shoulder seams, or you have back seam also. In my case, I have 3 seams here. I have shoulder seam, and back seam. No, well, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take a little bit in each one of them, cut this tag off and take a little bit in each one of them. Okay, with this one my goal achieved. As you can see, I took in each seam, 2 shoulders and back one, 1.5 inches. I took 3/4 on each side of seam, here and here, which is make 1.5 inches in each one. It's mean my neck cut altogether got smaller, whole 4.5 inches. Perfect. I got perfect coverage. That was my purpose, and I got perfect coverage for my walking on the sun as much as possible, because sun create troubles for women's skin. You know that it's a lot of wrinkles created and everything else. Next. Okay, next will be these 2 beauties. It's identical tops, 100% cotton, and it was for such a sales. I got like for $4.50 each. That's why I got 2 of them. And next is big again. This one is a little bit wider, as you can see, and this one, no, actually this one a little bit too wider. And well, I obviously have to close, but my problem is here. I am only working with 2 seams. I have only 2 seams, which is on the shoulders right here. No, well, how about I will take that one, which is smaller one, I will take only in 2 seams in the shoulders, which is I'm not gonna show to you that, because it's so easy. This one is just like, this is your shoulder seam, you put pin right here and take it in, cut rest, because t-shirt material will not run. Put on the both sides like I did with this t-shirt. Let's go back to it. See how I did? I put this seam on the both sides to make it flat, but it's not gonna bother me from inside, and stitch it flat like that with same color of thread here. What it's not shows, my alterations is not shows. No, well, that's what you do, identical here. But one of them, which is way too big neck, I have to take someplace else besides shoulders. No, well, let me show to you how I'm gonna do it. Okay, guys, Actually, after I took in shoulders, I'm satisfied now with the size of my neck cut. I'm perfectly satisfied. It's good to wear as it is, it's good to wear with a scarf, it's good to wear with a denim jacket. Well, but anyway, in case you meet this problem and you took any shoulders and still not enough, and it is no back seam like in the first t-shirt to take it in, make that seam. And in this case, I will make it probably, because it's pattern going on here, I will make that seam like it's going like pattern, like exactly in the middle of here. I will make seam like that, very much hidden, right here. Like that, just pin it and stitch it. Make sure you don't stitch it too rapidly finish. Go a little bit more down. And well, to make sure what it's gonna be for you, it's gonna be something like exactly in my case, because it's, I believe, right in the middle, right here between the distance will be the sleeve. No, well, instead going by side of leaf, it should go exactly to that leaf somewhere. To make sure like that leaf will be kind of like part of pattern, like it's meant to be. Something like that. Something like that all the way down there. But if you don't want to button with that, okay, take tags off and make that seam on the back and take a smidge there. But if you take it on the back, I will not suggest you to take in a one seam. And so is right here too. You don't have to take it in one seam. You can make two little ones. Depend what you're dealing with. Go by style. Do not break that style. Like for example, make two seams here. Tiny ones like that. Just a tiny one. Make four of them. Make as many of them as you want to. What it will take care about that. It's gonna be just a smidge, little smidge right here. And depend what you're dealing with. See, by time what you stitch it, see when I'm pulling like that? If you stitch it properly, you don't even will see the seams, especially if it's small ones. And you can kind of line them up and go from that purpose, what you need it for. You need more cleavage, you need less cleavage, what actually coverage you after. Always go by style. Next, let's go look on a sweater or cardigan. This cardigan have a problem again, 100 cotton, beautiful cardigan, but no, look how huge is this neck cut. And it's kind of killing whole purpose of a cardigan to get something warmer on you, to get some kind of coverage. No, well, let's deal with that. How are we gonna deal with it? Always go by style, which is already here. And what is here? Four seams, because it's raglan. One, two, right here seam, another one there. And what you can do, take a little bit in each one. All right, as you can see, my Isaac Mizrahi sweater become totally wearable. And if you think it's become too Grammy-ish closed, no, because it's have buttons, I can always open up, right? And this sweater now is ready for my video about styling sweaters. No, well, subscribe, but you will not miss that one. And it can be wear with black dress pants with some nice poly top under in open version, just to show more body. You don't want to close neck too far. And you can wear it as it is with all the neck closed as a sweater instead cardigan, just with blue jeans for more casual occasion. And it's very wearable sweater. And with this neck cut, and you can see, because I took 1.5 inches in each seam, which is comes to what, 4 times 1.5 inches, it's like 6 inches. 6 inches. It was completely crazy cut right here. It stretched out in one washing. It was completely crazy cut. And now it's become even more designer look, because it's kind of more close to square as just totally round one. No, well, that's how you do it with always go by style, follow style and purpose, what you need it for. That's how you take it in the neck. And okay, guys, this is number 3 video with different version of taking in the neck, V-neck, round neck, how we do it. One more coming video about that, and it's gonna be about how to change style. Like here I practically change style of neck, and how to change style neck and go from something too big, too smaller on the neckline, and have that designer look, have different shape of neck and purpose, much more wearable. Thank you guys, subscribe if you would, you will not miss none of it. Thank you for your time.